I don't think I've ever hated a show more in my life. Listen to me when I say they will never go away. Run,
run. Welcome to the jungle.
I've never been a fan of Riverdale, never really liked any modern teen drama because they're so soapy. And while Netflix is known for its teen melodramas, this one caught me a little off guard. Why did this show bother me so much? Especially since I have no nostalgic attachment to any of the originals, I'm coming into this with a completely open mind. Is it because it didn't live up to my expectations? Am I just being too picky? Maybe I've outgrown the genre and I have no say, or maybe there's more to it. This is the first time a show has actually given me whiplash. For those of you who liked any of the original Winx episodes, I am so sorry. Not just because the reboot is so brain dead, but the Winx is just a boring show in general. I grew up with Cartoon Network, good old fashioned Scooby-Doo, and Courage the Cowardly Dog. But hey, what is childhood without a little bit of trauma? Return the slab. Oh, suffer my curse. I've heard good things about the original Winx show. Kids' cartoons these days are all about love and friendship and pillow fights and sleepovers and boys. Though I also watched Sailor Moon as a kid, so maybe I'm not one to talk. This is exactly why the Winx Fate Saga piqued my interest. Not only was I curious to see what kind of twist they would turn the Winx into as far as a realistic setting, but the dark academia look is pretty in right now. And hey, even if it did turn out to be the shallow, superficial trill I expected, it might provide good cringe, and boy, did it deliver on that. There are a multitude of reasons to make an example of the show, multiple different videos I could have made on the poor writing qualities and the tropes and toxic traits that make the characters so damn unlikable. But everyone else has already done that, and I did mean it when I said I didn't want to keep making negative reviews for the sake of making reviews. But I am a firm believer that us writers, readers, and viewers, we can glean a lot, sometimes more, from exploring the faults of a poor example of writing rather than a better one. Sometimes it's harder to pinpoint the whys in the good examples because that's the art of making it good. It's subtle. The problems in the Winx Fate Saga are all the side effects of one greater issue that contributes to the unending weightlessness of the plot, branching to affect every area of it and even poisoning the characters' smaller storylines in the process. So in this video, I would like to explore that. No story is going anywhere without some sort of setup, and if you've never watched the original Winx, never fear, because here's an entirely new cast of characters reusing the same names and powers without any of the actual substance or merit is here to, well, let you know that they're here, basically. What role they play, and of course, what element they possess. Adding weight to your story all starts in the setup. Your readers are going to be at peak curiosity here because of the level of potential at the beginning. Everything is new to them, everyone is new to them, and there's this whole new world to explore, so where do we start? Well, the tour guides, essentially. And there are plenty of ways to make your characters interesting. Give them a snarky personality, a really cool superpower, a familiar archetype anyone can recognize or relate, or just make sure they're good looking. One that has been overused in recent times is the tragic backstory. You've heard it all before, the overpowered girl, the chosen one with a chip on her shoulder, has been holding herself back because of some dark event that happened long ago. They're usually portrayed as being strong because of their cold exterior, their recklessness and mistakes have forced them to play by their own rules and live with a consequences, but this one is flat as an ironing board. Oh, but she has all this inner turmoil that's holding her back, and if she only looked inside to face it, she could become the most powerful. Yeah, no, there's none of that either. I'm going to get into the reasons why the characters don't give as much as they do in the show, but I do want to start off by stating that making a crux out of a single instance that might have been more devastating if it had more emotional merit is not the best bait and switch for your viewers. Don't get me wrong, what happened to Bloom's mother was terrible. I mean, in this show, it's her parents who are really the victims, and they're almost painted like the bad guys. Bloom accidentally sets fire to the house because she was really angry, and her mother gets third-degree burns, her parents have to rebuild their home, and then, you know, live with her. So who's really the victim in this scenario? Bloom isn't exactly racked with guilt about it or remorse either. She uses it for sympathy points to get friends. She uses it as an excuse to push people away and then proceeds to drag said people into every reckless decision she continues to make despite their best efforts to talk her out of it. Then proceeds to blame them for her mistakes. I didn't want to mention gaslighting, but I think it's all too ironic not to. If you had to start off Bloom's story with an actual loss, say her father and her didn't get along, and then she accidentally killed him in the blast because after setting it, she couldn't save him and then had to go live with her mother, have her racked with guilt, this would be a more substantial reasoning for her fear. It would at least be rooted in a decent backstory that we could kind of backtrack and understand a little bit more from her. And then she would have that inner conflict that she would have to constantly be warring with, this guilt that's feeding into the fear of using her power, and that's where that inner conflict would actually bloom, if you pardon the pun. But if anything, this instance has merely fueled her curiosity. Fears seem more or less misplaced and just fake. It feels fake. Some of the most important weight you can add to your story is that of world building. You set a code, a set of rules or laws that your characters should live by. What most writers don't seem to understand is the rules are also meant for you. This is what we call free writing. Usually this is done on a first draft or a second, but after much thought and consideration, the writer tends to go back to the drawing table and starts noticing the holes in their story, as well as how boring their world would be if they had to step in and help their characters out of every impossible situation. I feel like this step is especially overlooked when discussing writing. I get that if you're writing a fantasy novel about elves and trolls and such, you're not going to care if a character's skin color is green and then magically changes to magenta the minute they get their first unicorn. But your readers will have questions if you then proceed to explain how the unicorn is actually the troll's cousin and their expecting cousin has come from another planet to take them all away on a rocket ship. Bear in mind, I'm not talking about parodies, satirical pieces, or Chuck Palahniuk. You're not above plot holes, and as soon as you start introducing clues as to how your world works, or as in the Winx case, both worlds connected throughout the realm, and then the magic that has been used to cover up another past, there are no rules. No real laws here. The characters are helped out of any situation by some magical MacGuffin or somebody popping up out of nowhere to help. You have these magical gates and force fields, and you manage to hide an entire city of ruins, but then you decide that your war room is best hidden in a closet.
Bruh.
If your audience is sitting there constantly asking questions about conundrums in your story they'll never have an answer for, you might want to patch up at least some of these holes because the roof is pretty leaky and it's only a matter of time before the whole structure collapses. Bloom wasn't the only problematic character in the series. Every fairy had their vices. They were more at each other's throats than they were helping each other through their problems, which I found to be a bit contradictory. I kept asking, why do you like each other? Why are you even around each other? All you do is argue. Their actions and everything they talk about relates to nothing more than shallow, superficial interest. There's a slight element of mystery with Musa hiding to make out with her roommate's brother in an obviously public place. Good God, man, at least find a broom closet or something. Or the air fairy, I can't remember her name, but she's the most interesting person in the show because she's the only one who we get any answers out of, even if they are half answers, to explain some of the secrecy of what's going on. Growing up on Sailor Moon, I can remember Mars and Serena going at it, like, a lot. They were always arguing, fighting, making each other cry, sometimes it could get violent, and sometimes it could get ugly. But by the end of the day, you realize that they were like sisters and that they would really be there for each other, and they managed to actually uphold each other in the tougher times instead of constantly chiding each other on what they need to do better. The other characters had personalities to balance this out also, so it wasn't just a constant pointing fingers bickering contest. And this is what made it balanced, and this is what made it comedic, is these girls had all these different personalities that tended to mesh together, and they were able to come together as one. They were multifaceted, multidimensional characters with more than one personality trait. With the Winx fairies, their personalities only extended to their powers, and how they could use them to get what they want. I realize Aisha helps Bloom more than once, but then proceeds to chide her, judge her, and threaten her. Not a very understanding relationship, and the other fairies are just kind of there. They have nothing in common. If you want to add weight to your characters, they need to be human. They need to have a level of understanding, and getting them to come together under even one commonality would have to make it pretty fucking important. Take The Breakfast Club, for example. Characters who should by all means hate each other, and they do when they're blending in with a crowd, but then stick them in a room together, forced to make conversation, makes them realize they're not so different. That commonality being a very strong inner conflict, struggling to be their own person in a world that would deem them invisible. Winx? Nah, fire powers. Oh, and wings, but we didn't really give them a setup for that, so we'll just edit and post. There's a running theme in this show. Imagine you're line dancing. I don't know how or what type, but you know when you're taking hands and just dancing in a circle? Wait. Okay. Ring around the rosy. That's something I can relate to. Imagine you're just going with the flow, following the next person in line, just trying to keep up and do your part. Out of nowhere, somebody comes and jerks you out of the ring to force you into theirs. Yeah, it's like that. The whole point of a drama is to build suspense. The tension starts to get tighter, and you can get tiny hints and clues throughout to pique your interest and kind of trail you along, following the breadcrumbs just a little bit more, hooking you in, waiting for that quiet release when suddenly it's brushed off. Turns out it wasn't that big of a deal. Turns out this wasn't fundamental for the characters to develop. Turns out all we needed was a cheap setup for the sequel. I have never been more flabbergasted than I was at the end of the last episode. Or I think it was the second to last episode, I don't really care. They actually did the "your parents aren't who you think they are" twist twice. Once in the first episode, and then again in the last one. They did the "your world is not what you think it is" twist twice. They did the "you were taken from your real parents" twist twice. Winx Fate Saga is the only instance I've seen that actually copied their own origin backstory twist from the first episode of the same season. And then they proceeded to play head games with the main character and its audience with this back and forth cat and mouse game of who's the real bad guy. Ominous music aside, the headmistress could just be a really good manipulator. But then we get to find out at the last moment when the academy starts to take on the appearance of the Third Reich's headquarters, Rosalie might be the bad guy just to tease another season. This show made me never want to watch another fairy movie ever again, no matter how much I liked the Tinkerbell series. All the problems I've mentioned before really could have been solved by one thing. That thing that's going to give your characters an arc and make them human again. That thing that's going to solve the boredom that would normally kill your story off if it weren't for the cheap twists you're repeatedly placing throughout. It's going to help the structure of your world and keep the laws of the land safe from every writer's limp-wristed attempt to step in and help. And it will make your setup actually matter. Because no matter what you say about the Winx being compared to the last, no one can deny the glaring issue with this entire series. And that is the lack of consequence. For every action, there is a reaction. And according to Newton's third law, it's pretty damn important. This means that whenever a character says or does something in your story, they need to be held accountable at present or sometime in the future. When Bloom is treating her friends like shit and getting them in trouble, this isn't going to make her likable, certainly not popular, and just because they're sweet mates doesn't mean that these girls are obligated to have lunch with her. When the kids are caught up by the higher-ups going outside the realm and the headmistress says, "There will be consequences," we're not going to forget about that. But clearly you did, because nothing happens with it the entire show. Aisha even manages to get a spot as her secretary, which, go figure what she did to deserve that. And when Bloom lets a burned one into the real world just because she was a little homesick, we're not going to forget the danger she's putting everyone in. Holding your characters accountable doesn't just mean that they have to get a punishment for their actions, it's a learning moment. The fact is, none of these characters learn anything from their actions, and that is what makes them flat. Even by the end, when Bloom is being used by Rosalie, clearly stating how much power she intends to take by using Bloom as her helper, Bloom isn't repulsed by the realization that she's been tricked, manipulated, or that Rosalie is actually an incredibly dangerous individual. She cries because she's hurt that Rosalie isn't going to help her find her real parents, and that she's all alone after all and nobody cares about her. Bloom did nothing to earn her shining moment. This glorious transformation of power is supposed to be the end of an arc. It's supposed to be the moment where Bloom has worked out her inner conflicts and realizes that she's been held back by something. I guess in this case, it should have been fear, but if we don't have the alternating argument of, proper use of emotion and bad use of emotion, because apparently there's a darker method Stella uses, and we get no more exploration of this. We see Bloom just become more powerful over time because of, what, practice? But the whole idea for this show was that magic equals emotion, and the key is control. So where is Bloom's control when she's blindly running into fights, getting everyone in trouble, and doesn't know who to side with? If you're going to make your character powerful, they not only need to earn it, they need a reason to be, otherwise there's no point. I guess a reason in this case would be the place is overrun with burned ones, so smoke them out. But then again, she goes looking for them in the same reckless manner that she did before, and then is rewarded with super magic, even though she's exhibited little control or reasoning and only just found her superpowers a year ago. When it usually takes a lifetime for these other fairies to learn about them, there aren't any consequences, and this erases all purpose to your character. Their actions should matter, and they won't unless there are drawbacks. It's through the conflict that they find themselves. Instead, it's just an aimless witch's hunt to find out who's the bad guy. In conclusion, I think Winx Fate Saga was a stupid show. Not because it didn't stay true to any of its source material, it had me at Dark Academia, it had me at Fire Fairy with tragic backstory, it had me at The Academy is Full of Dark Mystery and Secrets. It lost me after the first episode. Bloom made incredibly terrible decisions and had no remorse, learned nothing from her actions, and instead used these moments as a crux for her own ego. Side note to you writers, when using the tragic backstory, it's completely pointless if they've learned nothing from it. People aren't automatically stronger because bad things simply happen to them. They're made strong when they rise in opposition to those things tearing them down, holding them back, or holding power over them. That's the key. Winx Fate Saga had a lot of potential, and they had a lot to work with. The execution was just terrible. I really wish writers today would get their heads out of their own ass, because personally, I'm tired of every TV show, every book, and every piece of media that's written exactly like this. I mean, soap operas have more substance, and they never even get an ending. But if your only purpose is to tease a major twist coming up, dragging the readers or viewers along, and it ends up being the same twist you pulled at the beginning, what are you doing? Everything should come around full circle. I don't care how good your gotcha is. If you haven't set it up right, or you have highly unlikable characters and there is no purpose or meaning behind any of them, their words, or their actions, nobody's gonna care. And I think I can say the same for Winx Fate Saga.